हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे लेट्स स्टार्ट्स फिगर्स ऑफ स्पीच ऑफ पोएम नंबर 2 द सोअर ऑफ 11th स्टैंडर्ड इंग्लिश. नाउ वी विल सी विच फिगर्स ऑफ स्पीच आर देयर इन ईच एंड एवरी लाइन. फर्स्ट लाइन, सिटिंग इन अ पोर्च वे कूल. व्हाट इज द फिगर ऑफ स्पीच? इन्वर्जन, बिकॉज the sentence construction is grammatically not correct. It means s plus v plus o, subject plus verb plus object. In this way the structure is not there, that's why it is inversion. Second line, sunlight I see dying fast. Alliteration is there because the sound of the letter s or s, we can say in Marathi, so s is repeated. Sunlight, yes in sunlight, and again yes in sea. But second figure of speech is also there, inversion, because the sentence construction is not grammatically correct. I see sunlight dying fast, so this is the correct sentence, so that's why inversion is there. Third figure of speech is also there, and it is personification, because sunlight has been given the animate quality of dying. Dying, this quality is of human being, and this quality is given to sunlight, so that's why it is personification. Next line, twilight hastens on to rule. Personification is there because twilight has been given the animate quality of hastening, so that's why it is personification. Next line, shadows run across the lands. Personification is there because shadows have been given the animate quality of running. Running, this quality is of human being, but it is given to shadows, so that's why personification. Next line, but a sore lingers still. Inversion is there because the sentence construction is not in grammatical order. It is because for the poetic effect. It means not all the sentences, all the lines are wrong, but it is for the poetic effect, so that's why it is inversion. Alliteration is also there because the sound s is repeated. S in sore, s in still. Next line, old in rays he patient stands. Inversion is there because the sentence construction is not in grammatical order, so it is inversion. Now next line, dominates the furrows deep. Inversion again, the sentence construction is not in grammatical order. In which way this sentence, this line, if you think about the grammatical order, then the furrows dominates deep. Next, alliteration is also there because D sound is repeated. D in dominates and D in deep. Next line, now to show the task is set. Alliteration is there because the sound of the letter S is repeated. S in so, S in set. Inversion is also there because the line is not grammatically correct, but it is used in the poem for the poetic effect, so it is inversion. Next line, soon shall come a time to reap. Inversion is there because the sentence construction is not in grammatically correct. Alliteration is also there because the sound of the letter S is repeated. S in soon, S in shall, so that's why alliteration. Next line, marches he long along the pain. Inversion, sentence construction is not in grammatically order. It is because poetic effect, so that's why inversion is there. To and fro and scatters wide. Antithesis is there because when two opposite words are placed side by side, then it is antithesis. See here, to and fro. In Marathi, eja karne asa apan jala manto. So antithesis is there. From his hands the precious grain. Inversion again, sentence construction is not in grammatical order. And alliteration is also there because S sound repeats. H in hands, and again H in his. Next line, muse I as I see him stride. Alliteration is there because S sound is repeated. S in see, S in stride. inversion is also there because sentence construction is not grammatically correct. And third figure of speech is also there, it is repetition. The word I repeated again and again. See, so that's why I, two times I is there, so that's why repetition is also there. Next line, darkness deepens, fades the light. Alliteration is there because D sound repeats, D in darkness, D in deepens. Antithesis is also there because two opposite words are there. See, darkness and light. So it is antithesis. Now his gestures to mine eyes, inversion is there because the sentence construction is not in is not grammatically correct. Synecdoche is there because the poet's eyes represents poet whole. Poet's eyes, it means not only that part. When the word used poet's eyes, it means complete poet. When whole is not single part is there, but whole is considered, then that time synecdoche is there. Now next line, are august and strange his height. Alliteration is there because H sound repeats again and again, H in his, H in height. Next line, seems to touch the starry skies. Alliteration is there because S and T, both sounds are repeated, S in seems, yes in starry, and T in touch to the, so that's why alliteration is also there. Next, hyperbole is also there. It means exaggeration and hyperbole, both words are same. Exaggeration of poet's greatness. Jevha atishayokti keleli aste, ahe tyachyapeksha jast sangitlele aste, seems to touch the starry skies. So really exaggeration is there. Exaggerate statement is here, so that's why it is exaggeration, or we can say hyperbole. So please, I think you understood this, all the figures of speech. Yache agodar jar aplyala figures of speech samjayche astil tar mi teen videos aplya pude taklele ahet ya YouTube channel var, te nichchit baga ani tyachyanantar tumhala he sagle figures of speech samastil. So please subscribe my channel. It's very simple process is given here for subscribing. And share to others. When you will share to others, then it is beneficial for all the students also and others also. So once again, I am thankful to all for watching my video. So thank you.